Google Analytics segments allow you to slice and dice your data to view data from different groups of users. This is useful for comparing how different groups of users interact with your site or for identifying trends in user behavior. There are a few different ways to view subsets of your users in analytics, so let's quickly define those before we dig in deeper. The first is comparisons, which allow you to compare subsets of data side by side in overview and detail reports in the reporting interface. We covered these in detail in a previous lesson. In contrast, segments allow you to analyze a subset of users, sessions, or events in exploration reports. You can apply up to 4 segments at a time in Explore reports to see how different subsets of data compare to each other. Finally, audiences are groups of users that share one or more characteristics that you define and can be created from scratch or from a segment that you've already created. Audiences can be shared and activated on ad platforms like Google Ads and Display and Video 360. For example, you might create an audience of users who exited your shopping cart without making a purchase, so you can re-engage with those users. Audiences can be used in comparisons in reporting, in remarketing campaigns, and as dimensions in reports. To use audiences in comparisons, select audience name as the dimension and select the audience as the dimension value. Let's walk through creating a new segment together. In this example, the Google merchandise store is launching a new line of sweaters, and their marketing team is looking to market the line to users who have made an apparel purchase on the site before. Let's create a segment for users who have previously purchased an item of clothing. We'll go into Explore and create a free form report. To create a segment from scratch, in the Variables pane, click the plus next to Segments. In the General Pre-built Suggestions section, select Purchasers. This will open up a pre-built segment for the users who have made a purchase that we can then continue to edit. Click And underneath the purchase condition and select Item Category Contains Apparel at any point in time. This should satisfy the criteria that the user purchased an apparel item. We'll name the segment Apparel Purchasers. To save, click Save and Apply in the upper right-hand corner. You can now see the report we opened, which looks at device category by city for active users, is being segmented to only include users who have completed an apparel purchase. After exploring this data with your segment, you might find the segment valuable enough that you'd want to use or export it as an audience for ad remarketing or bidding. There are 3 ways to create audiences. The first is to mark a segment as an audience from the segment creation screen. The second is to create an audience from a selection of data in the Explore report. And the last is to use the audience builder located in the admin section. To create an audience from the segment we just created, we'll open the segment back up by clicking the 3 dots that appear as you hover over the segment name and then clicking Edit. In the upper right-hand corner of the segment, you'll see a checkbox called Build an Audience. Click that checkbox. Doing so adds a couple of additional options to the screen where you can change the membership duration, set it to a maximum limit, or create an audience trigger. For this example, we'll leave the membership duration as 30 days and then click Save and Publish, which will now create this segment as an audience available for sharing. Here's a bonus tip. In the Additional Audience Settings box, there is also a button to create a new audience trigger. An audience trigger is a cool feature that will fire an event each time a user is added to an audience. In this example, we could have an event called Apparel Purchasers fire each time a new user purchased an item of apparel. This event would then be available to use for analysis in your reports and could also be marked as a key event or used to create a conversion for Google Ads optimization. The second way to build an audience is to do so from a selection in an Explore report. One of my favorite ways of doing this is from a funnel report to create an audience from funnel abandonment. If we open up a funnel we have already built, such as this checkout behavior funnel for tracking the steps of beginning checkout, adding billing and shipping info, reviewing and purchasing, we can choose a step to create an audience from. In this case, we'll right-click the box called Abandonment Rate underneath the Review step and select Create Segment from Abandonments. This will open up the segment builder with the conditions already applied to include users who got to step 3 but did not continue onto step 4 to purchase. In the upper right-hand corner of this screen, we'll again select the Build an Audience checkbox, choose our membership duration, and then hit Save and Publish. The last way to create an audience is to do so from scratch from the Audience Builder. Let's do that to build an audience for users who added an item to their cart but didn't make a purchase, which is similar to the funnel audience we just created. To get to the Audience Builder, you'll navigate to Admin, Data Display, and then Audiences, and then click New Audience, which will open up the Audience Builder. We'll start from scratch by selecting Create a Custom Audience. For this audience, you want to include users who triggered the Add to Cart event and exclude users who triggered the Purchase event. Under Include Users When, click Add New Condition and select the Add to Cart event. Below the Include condition, click Add Group to exclude. You'll notice that the option to exclude from audience temporarily is selected by default. This is based on the membership duration that you select for the audience. Next, click Add New Condition and select the Purchase event. At the top of the Audience Builder, where it says Untitled Audience, enter Cart Abandoners. In the field below that, where it says Add a Description, enter Users Who Left Items in Their Carts. Once the setup is complete and you're satisfied with the data shown in the summary card, hit Save to complete the audience. You should now know how to create and use segments in your analysis and create audiences either from a previously created segment, from an Explore report, or from scratch. Segments and audiences empower you to analyze data with precision and deliver personalized remarketing messages, ultimately driving stronger marketing results.